amino acids. So this amino acids also having that bio molecules. This amino acids having that different functional group. Generally, so this amino acids are having that amino group and carboxylic group. And hydrogen group and okay R functional group. So this R functional group is known as the alkyl group. It is that all functional group is known as that alkali group. So generally amino group and carboxyl group are present on the same carbon, they are known as that alpha amino acids. Alpha amino acids. For example, it is that amino group, it is that carboxyl group. Okay, amino group and carboxyl group both are present on the same carbon, so they are known as that alpha amino acids. Okay, totally four functional groups are present. It means hydrogen group, amino group, carboxylic group, hydrogen group and R group. So based on that R group, amino acids are different type of that amino acids. Amino group, carboxylic group, acid group, after that hydrogen group, after that R functional group. Based on that R functional group, so amino acids are different type. Okay, some are proteinaceous amino acids, proteinaceous amino acids are also present. Okay, so before explaining of the protein amino acids, so nucleic acid is also there. Some about that, it means some about that points of nucleic acids. So generally that nucleic acid also biomolecules, they are that heterocyclic compounds. Generally nucleic acids are, so it means they are that polynucleotide chains. In this nucleotide is known as building block of nucleic acid. Okay, generally so in the each nucleotide mainly three parts. For example, nitrogen base is connected to that pentose sugar. Okay, so nitrogen base and pentose sugar is present. They are known as nucleoside. Nucleoside, so nitrogen bases are, for example, adenine, guanine, guanine, thiamine, cytosine, uracil. Okay, for example, for nitrogen base plus pentose sugar is known as that nucleoside. So they are that nitrogen base are generally adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine and uracil are nitrogen bases. So this nucleoside, example adenosine, guanosine, thymidine, cytidine, after that uridine. They are that nucleoside. If nucleotide having, if nitrogen base and pentose sugar, only two components are present, so that is known as the nucleoside. Nitrogen base is attached to the pentose sugar by glycosidic bond. Okay, so that is known as adenosine. Example adenosine, guanosine, thymidine, cytidine and uridine. So these are the example for that, okay, nucleosides. After that, nucleotide having mainly three components. First one is the nitrogen base is connected to that pentose sugar means 5 carbon compound. So this nitrogen base I am also explained before that adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine and uracil. So this pentose sugar, either it is a DNA or RNA, is either DNA or RNA. Okay, so nitrogen base is connected to the pentose sugar by glycosidic bond. After that, phosphate group, it is known as that phosphoric acid, chemically it is a phosphoric acid, biologically it is known as that phosphate molecule. Important bit, due to the presence of phosphoric acid so nucleic acid, then nucleic acid having that acidic nature, so it is that important bit about that medical. Okay, so by that phosphate is attached to that, so pentose sugar of hydroxyl group, third and fifth carbon position, so that is known as that ester bond. Okay, so it is that by the ester bond, phosphoric acid is attached to pentose sugar by ester bond. I am explain after that, okay, bonding system. So that is known as phosphoric acid, biological they are known as that phosphate molecule. So it is known as that nucleotide. Okay, it is that important point. So this nucleotides are, okay, so building blocks of nucleic acid, right? Nucleotides, example Example, adrenic acid, guanolic acid, citric acid, thymidic acid, uridylic acid. So they are known as that nucleotides: adenylic acid, guanolic acid, citric acid, thymidic acid and uridylic acids. So after that, amino acids. So proteins are long chains. They are that made up, they are polypeptide chains. They are made up of different type of that amino acids. Okay, so generally amino acid having that 4 functional group. Okay, in that 4 functional group, one is that amino group, second one is that carboxylic group, third one is that hydrogen group, fourth one alkyl group. Okay, if amino group and carboxylic group both are present on the same carbon, so they are known as that alpha carbon. I am also explained that alpha amino acid. Okay, so these three functional groups, they do not change so in amino acid. Okay, but only alkyl group, so that is known as an alkyl group. So this alkyl group is only change based on the change of that alkyl group. So amino acids are different. For example, that proteinaceous amino acids generally there are three types. First one is that glycine, second one is that alanine, third one is that serine. So these are that proteinaceous amino acid. For example, you take that glycine formula. NH2 C COOH and H. Again, it is that H group. Okay, so in the glycine, alanine and serine. Okay, for example, in that alanine group, in the glycine, at the place of that R group, if H is present, that is known as a glycine. Alanine is NH2 C H CH3 and COOH. Okay, so first one is that hydrogen group at that fourth carbon position, so that is known as that functional group. The glycine, alanine means, so instead of that, okay, so H group. So for example, if a methyl group is present,